Jupiter is blue. Wait a minute. With giant storms, powerful winds, auroras, and extreme temperatures, pressure conditions, Jupiter has a lot going on. Now, NASA's James Webb Space Telescope has captured new images of the planet. Webb's Jupiter observations will give scientists even more clues to Jupiter's inner life. We hadn't really expected it to be this good, but it's really remarkable that we can see details on Jupiter together with its rings, tiny satellites, and even galaxies in one image. It's insane. The image looks gorgeous. The two images, actually, that James recorded come from the observatory's near-infrared camera, NIRCam, as formerly known, which has three specialized infrared filters that showcase details of the planet. Since infrared light is invisible to the human eye, the light has been mapped into the visible spectrum. So generally, the longest wavelengths appear redder and the shortest wavelengths are shown as more blue. It's not really blue, it's the coin of the interpretation of it. But who cares? It looks cool. I mean, scientists collaborated with citizen scientist Judy Schmidt to translate the web data into images. In the standalone view of Jupiter, they created a form of composite of several images from Webb. Auroras extend to the high altitudes above both the northern and southern poles of Jupiter. The auroras are so gorgeous, they shine in a filter that is mapped to redder colors, which also highlights light reflected from lower clouds and upper hazes. A different filter, mapped to yellows and greens, shows hazes swirling around the northern and southern poles. There's also a third filter, mapped to blues, which showcases light that is reflected from a deeper main cloud. Great red spot, the infamous, huge, iconic spot of Jupiter. It's a famous storm so big it could literally swallow Earth. But it appears white in these views, as do other clouds, because they are reflecting a lot of sunlight, apparently. The brightness here indicates high altitude, so the Great Red Spot has high altitude hazes, as does the equatorial region. However, the numerous bright white spots and streaks are very likely high-altitude cloud tops of condensed convective storms. By contrast, dark ribbons north of the equatorial region have little cloud cover. So, let's talk more about what Webb will see. In a wide field view, Webb sees Jupiter with its faint rings, which are a million times fainter than the planet actually is, and two tiny moons called Amaltea and Adrastea. The fuzzy spots in the lower background are likely galaxies photobombing this view, which is quite iconic, if you tell me. This one image sums up the science of our Jupiter system program, which studies the dynamics and chemistry of Jupiter itself, its rings, and its satellite. This program is led by Fauchet, and there's a bunch of other researchers have already begun analyzing this Webb new data to get new science results about our solar system's largest planet. I mean, to be honest, this is all very exciting, and James Webb Telescope has been unraveling image after the other, and we are so excited. We are in what we call a James Webb era, so everything we are seeing from Webb is transforming the view of how we see the universe, and we're so excited. If you want to know more about Webb's latest incredible discovery on WASP-96 or other incredible nebulas, then click this video right here because we delve into that. Otherwise, thank you for watching this channel and stay tuned and updated because we will be going every single day or every 2 days about videos concerning Webb because we are so excited. We can't wait to show and see what's gonna come up next. So thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.